Dr. Bratzman is the author of the best-selling textbook, Clinical Orthopedic Rehabilitation, which is now in its fourth edition and is an international bestseller for Missy, Harcourt, and Elsevier. It is now translated in 13 different languages.
Good afternoon and welcome to this edition of, hey, I just had a knee surgery and I don't remember anything they told me. One of the problems with the knee scopes and ACLs, that type of thing, is that you typically, we give you anesthesia, you're a bit amnestic, so everything makes sense as we're telling it to you, but unfortunately you kind of forget it later on, and at this point you're like, I'm not sure what they told me. So this video is going to go over what we need you to do post-op. Now typically there's three kinds of folks that come with you to the surgery center to help you. The first one is the husband or the boyfriend, and they're going to remember about 35% of what we told you, boyfriend maybe 45%. Wives are going to be much better. They're going to remember about 85%, but it's all going to be factual. So the part I tell them about giving foot rubs or sponge baths, that's going right out the window. You're not going to get that, so you may want to watch this. And then finally, the third one is, you know, your roommate, your next door neighbor, or the Uber driver. They're just going to kind of tuck and roll. They're going to shoot you out the door, and you're in the bedroom, and now you don't know what you're doing. So the purpose of this is to give you all the things you need to do after your knee surgery. Here's what's going on in the knee. First, your knee swells up after the surgery. Your body's putting down some inflammatory fluid, and it tends to, a lot of times, it'll collect right up here in your pouch above your knee. But that's a problem. There's something called the quad inhibition reflex. Whenever there's swelling in the knee, it goes to your spine and it shuts down your quad muscle. So immediately, right after the surgery, your thigh muscle is starting to shrink down. So we don't want to have a big swollen knee. It hurts more. It's shutting down your quad through the quad inhibition reflex, and it could gap open your incisions. So we do want you to elevate, but the problem is, if you put the pillow underneath your knee is sitting bent, and your hamstrings will tighten up and to a point where you'll form some scar tissue, and it becomes hard to straighten your leg as you're walking. So we do want a little bit of elevation, but we want to put the pillow just at the ankle so that your knee is straight. That elevates it just a little bit, and it keeps the knee straight. Because if you sit around with a pillow under your knee and your hamstrings tighten up, you can really have a problem later on trying to walk because of that scar tissue. Sometimes you can even be hanging out with just no pillow if that feels uncomfortable, and we're doing our icing and those kind of things. But if you're going to put something behind your, to elevate it, just one pillow under your ankle. The next thing that's going on is the scar tissue is forming. So we make two small arthroscopic incisions, or with the ACL, we're making some other small incisions. So the good scar tissue is healing this area, but the bad scar tissue is forming and limiting your motion, so you may lose some of your motion afterwards if we don't have you working on regaining that motion. Now I'm going to tell Brittany to try to bend her knee up for us. Just go ahead and bend your knee on the bed, and it won't be as easy as that. You'll struggle a little bit, but you can work on doing it this way. The more motion, the better, the earlier the better, because you will lose motion pretty quickly after a knee surgery, so we do want you working on bending your leg quite a bit. One of the other ways I like to help cheat and get that range of motion is you can get up on your kitchen cabinet and hang your leg down. Let's say your leg is kind of sore and it's your motion's only to here. What you can do is have gravity help you. You can kind of let the gravity help you, and you can guide it with your other leg so that it's not so painful. Then once you get to 90 degrees, you can bring this leg in front and push down until it feels tight. Hold that for 30 seconds, relax, and then you can push it again. And that way gravity is helping you and you're guiding it painlessly with your own other leg. Another issue that's going on is that we don't want you to get a blood clot. Typically you're walking around, you know, and you're getting lots of pumping action of your muscles, bringing back the your blood flow through your veins to the heart. But when you're in a bandage or in a brace and you're just hanging out on the bed, you're not getting quite as much of that pumping action. So we're gonna have to do some things to bring that back, that blood flow. The next set of exercises we'd like you to do is doing a lot of ankle pumps where you're pumping your ankle up and down on both sides. When you've had surgery and you're not getting your venous return, there's a chance of a blood clot. She's doing 200-300 of these a day. It's her calf musculature is stripping back her blood flow to her heart, minimizing the chance of a blood clot. But if your insurance allows us to do it, we're going to put on these sequential compression stockings. And they basically go on your leg, on the calf, and the little black box, per se, goes on the front. and I'm not going to do it all for the, but you put all three of those on, and then you push the button, and there's, you can either have program one or two, either one is fine. But what these little compression stockings do is they help bring back your venous return to minimize your chance of a blood clot. They'll recharge up overnight, and they'll last for 8 hours. And studies say to use them 3 to 5 hours a day whenever you're laying around the bed a lot and you're not getting that compression of your veins returning your blood flow to your heart. The next thing that's going on is that you're starting to lose your musculature. As you can tell, Brittany's a really good athlete. She's got a really nice quad that she's probably worked on for a number of years. It's really unfair, but after knee surgery, that'll literally shut down the quad, and it'll be half the size of the other one in just a few days. You don't want that to happen after your knee surgery. So now Brittany's going to do what I call a quad set. So push your knee down into the bed. So she's visualizing pushing her knee down. It makes her muscle contract. Relax. Push your knee down. Relax. That's engaging her quadricep muscle, and it's keeping it from atrophying. And it's also helping it, a lot of times your brain kind of forgets how to fire it, so it's helping to reinitiate that. But a couple hundred of those a day will help your thigh muscle keep from shrinking down. The next thing that we'd like you to do is leg lifts, which also are engaging this quadricep muscle. So we'd like you to do it perfectly straight if you can, and she'll just lift it up a few inches and come back down. Nice. And one more time, come back down. Again, you can see her nice quad muscle firing there. That's keeping it from atrophying. Now, sometimes it's too painful in the first couple days to do the leg lift, so if you can just do the quad sets, that's fine, but we need that muscle firing. So let's have a quick recap on how we get to becoming the utopian patient, the kind of patient where we're all sitting around in the nursing lounge talking about you, and Mrs. Johnson, she is the best, just like Brittany. So let's give the recap. What is Mrs. Johnson doing to make everything perfect? Well, when she goes home, she puts one pillow under her ankle. She's doing several hundred ankle pumps a day to keep from getting that blood clot, several hundred leg lifts a day to keep from her thigh shrinking down, a couple hundred quad sets a day to keep her thigh from shrinking. She's bending her knee to keep that motion going so the scar doesn't form. If you don't have an aspirin allergy or any contraindications for aspirin, we'd like you to take one 325 milligram bare aspirin or any kind of aspirin a day for the first 2 weeks to minimize your chance of a blood clot. Now, if you're on a blood thinner, we have to ask your doctor who's running that. Some folks are already on a blood thinner, and we'll have to resume that per that doctor's orders. So one aspirin a day, 325 milligrams for 2 weeks if you don't have an aspirin problem or if you're not already on a blood thinner. Do not immerse your knee in any type of lake water or bathtub water. Because you have some micro openings, we don't want water leaking into the incisions. In a lot of practices, they'll just tell you just to keep the incisions dry, and you can kind of work around it in the shower, and that's probably okay. In our own practice, what we'll often do is we'll have you take off the ACE bandage, cut through the white cottony material, and then before you get in the shower, we give you a Tegaderm, which comes like this, and then you'll unwrap the wrapper, and it's sticky. And then what we like you to do is just put the Tegaderm over the incision, and now it's fairly waterproof, and then shower away, shower all you want, blot it dry, then you just pull the Tegaderm off. You don't want to leave it on. You pull it off, and then you just put two small Band-Aids or bigger Band-Aids if it's an ACL, put Band-Aids over the incisions, and then rewrap your ACE bandage. Rewrap it from here to upwards so that you don't cause swelling. And not super tight, just where it's laying on the leg. Don't put any goop or peroxide or anything on there. The dermatologists say that you can use Aquaphor, and if you have to put something on there, you can put Aquaphor. Otherwise, please don't put anything on the incisions. Now let's talk about one of the things that we often do for folks afterwards, which is giving some ice or cryotherapy. Interestingly, when you have ice on the area of the surgery, it vasoconstricts or tightens the blood vessels so that they're not letting off as many inflammatory cells. So we can either use bags of ice and water, or a lot of times you'll have this cryotherapy unit, which has a sleeve that goes over to a pump that goes to a reservoir. Now here's the big key on the ice. You never ever want to have ice directly on the skin. You've always got to have an ACE bandage between you and the sleeve, or a towel or something, because this gets really, really cold, which is great for the knee. But unfortunately, this sleeve, if you lay this directly on the skin, can give you frostbite or freezer burn, and you get a huge, horrific scar. And on the ice machine, we typically tell folks to use it 2 hours on, 1 hour off to give the skin some rest. while they're awake, and you don't have to do it at nighttime. For ice bags, same thing. You can just put the ice bags with ice and water, which is a little colder than just ice. So put your ice bags of ice and water, again, not directly on the skin. And you can use those every couple of hours for 15, 20 minutes with the ice bags. Okay, now let's have the famous crutch talk. It's always an entertaining one when you've had lots of drugs and you're a little amnestic and you're kind of wobbling around. Have somebody kind of help you up out of the bed because you may be a little orthostatic, which means that when you're standing up, you may feel lightheaded. So sit at the edge of the bed for a few seconds and then have somebody help you up. You're either weight-bearing is tolerated with your crutches, or we may make you non-weight-bearing with no weight on it, which is pretty rare. So Brittany now is, in her athletic self is going to demonstrate weight-bearing is tolerated with crutches. Imagine your knee has a scab on the inside of it, and we're trying to take some pressure off the scab. But we do want you to put some weight on it because otherwise everything's going to atrophy. So she is putting weight on it, but she's taking pressure off of the crutches so that we're not making the surgical site angry. Okay, one of the other things we're going to talk about is PRP, which is platelet-rich plasma. So what will happen is when you're in surgery, we draw your blood off and we spin it down and we get just a platelet component of it and we inject it into the areas that we want to, and we will have discussed that. The interesting thing about PRP is we'd like you to try not to use anti-inflammatories for the first 4 to 6 weeks after surgery, because the anti-inflammatories will decrease the effect of the platelet-rich plasma. What are anti-inflammatories? That's like Advil, Aleve, ibuprofen. You can use Tylenol, you can use your pain medications, but with the anti-inflammatories, unfortunately, they will decrease the effect of the PRP.
Okay, so let's quickly summarize what we're gonna do for the 2 weeks after our knee surgery. We're gonna elevate our limb, but no pillow behind the knee. Ice, but no ice directly on the skin. We're gonna rest. We wanna get around the house with trips to the bathroom and the kitchen and the living room and the bedroom, but not walking down to Liberty Hill. We wanna do our exercises so that we don't shrink away to a chicken leg and we don't have a stiff knee. So we're gonna do range of motion, leg lifts, ankle pumps, quad sets. We're gonna protect our incisions. We're not gonna touch the incisions with our hands, because our hands have strep and staph germs on them that can infect the incisions. We're not gonna immerse our incisions in the hot tub or the ocean or the pool or even the bath, because there's micro openings and that can leak bad germs into our incisions. We're really just not gonna play with our incisions and put goop on it. If you need to put something on there, Aquaphor is acceptable. We're gonna use our sequential compression stockings if we have them. If we don't, we're gonna do lots of ankle pumps. We're gonna take an aspirin a day if there's not a reason why we can't take aspirin. If you're on blood thinners, then you're not gonna take the aspirin and you'll use the blood thinners as your doctor recommended. When we get up to the side of the bed, we're gonna wait there for a second and make sure everything equilibrates so that we don't get dizzy and fall down. We're gonna use our crutches and not try to be macho and tell the doctor, oh, I didn't need those crutches, so I didn't use them after 2 days, which is just putting more pressure on the inflamed area that we've just operated on. We wanna be pretty minimalistic on our narcotics because there's lots of potential side effects with narcotics, including constipation, itching, development of a tolerance or an addiction. So we are going to use them, but we're not gonna go crazy and we're not gonna take them if we're not having pain. If we're running temp over 101.5, then you'll need to let the doctor know. If you have low grade temp, that's usually atelectasis, which means that your lungs during the anesthesia contract down a bit and we want to re-expand them. You can buy a $7 incentive spirometer on Amazon where you suck really hard on the incentive spirometer and that will help you re-expand your lungs. That basically goes on 10 times every 2 hours for the first few days until you're not febrile. If we're using a brace, like an ACL surgery, typically we lock the brace at 0 degrees or straight for the first 2 weeks until you have a beautiful leg lift with no bend in your knee when you do that. Once you have that, that implies that your quad is strong enough to not have your knee buckling and potentially tearing your graft. So if you're using a brace on your knee, braces on with weight bearing and crutches, brace off in the bed, brace off in the bending machine. For different surgeries, the bending machine regimen is a bit different. Typically, we start out at 0 to 50 degrees a day and go up 10 degrees a day, and your orders may change this up a little bit. We'll tell you if we did. Usually, we just use that bending machine for 3 to 5 hours a day for the first week or so, unless you're getting behind on motion. At this point, it's very exciting that you've now had some good things going on in the knee with the surgery to get you back on the road to recovery. And hopefully this will help you speed it up so that you don't shrink down or stiffen or have a longer rehab or a longer recovery. Thanks.